11, Jason Holler. At second base, number 2, Mitch Lewis. Tonight's designated hitter, wearing number 34, Joe Patterson. Playing third base, number 27, Will Jellick. On the hill tonight for the River Rats, number 29, Owen Anderson. And now for your River Falls Fighting Fish. Leading off and playing center field, number 24, Brian Giebel. Batting second, playing shortstop, number 2, Trey Larson. Batting third, the right fielder, number 10, the white hot Ty Denzer. Batting cleanup, playing second base, number 3, Lucas Lukey. Batting fifth and playing first base, number 28, Spencer Diedrich. Batting sixth and catching tonight, number 25, Andy Metcalf. Batting seventh and playing third base, number 13, Carter Elliott. Tonight's designated hitter, number 21, Trevor Gooding. Playing left field and wearing number 7, Josh Item. And pitching tonight for the Fighting Fish, number 19, Charlie Griffin.
Chucky Batts on the mound tonight for the Fighting Fish. There's your starting lineup for the Fighting Fish again. It'll be Giebel, Larson, Denzer, Ludke, Diedrich, Metcalf, Elliott, Gutting, Item, with Charlie Griffin on the mound tonight for your River Falls Fighting Fish. Again, for the Hudson River Rats, Nate Whitty will lead off. Sam Erickson will bat second. Isaiah Grandkorvitz will bat third. Jack Erickson will bat fourth. Hunter Fry will bat fifth. Jason Holler will bat sixth. Mitch Lewis will bat seventh. Designated hitter Joe Patterson will bat eighth. And Will Jellick will bat ninth. Owen Anderson will be on the mound tonight for the Hudson River Rats. Again, Whitty, Erickson, Grandkorvitz, Erickson, Fry, Holler, Lewis, Patterson, Jellick, and Owen Anderson on the bump for the Hudson River Rats. Nice night for baseball here at First National Bank at River Falls Field. Both teams have taken their infield and outfield. Looks like we're going to have a meeting at home plate. And then I think they're headed towards home plate. There they go. Josh Item and the umpires. Then we're going to have National Anthem. And then first pitch. It's a little bit behind schedule. There was an American Legion game before this, but we are close. Welcome aboard, everybody. A lot of pointing. All right, lineups have been exchanged, ground rules have been gone over, and we are about set for the national anthem, our Star Spangled Banner, the Star Spangled Banner, our national anthem.
What's going on? How's your mom doing?
Greg Peters, our public address announcer this evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the ceremonial first pitches.
First pitches first.
Representing Johnny Farr and throwing out tonight's ceremonial first pitch, the man, the myth, the legend.
And that's not. It's a big deal. It's not. No, it's not.
Edgar Dentman.
Here he comes.
And representing the River Falls Swim Club, she's a future Olympic swimmer, no doubt about it, Madison Nelson.
Madison Nelson from
Madison
the swim club. Madison and Edgar making their way out.
Andy Metcalf better have a padding behind that catcher's net.
They're ready to bring the heat. The cheese, the heat, bring it. All right, Edgar, let her rip.
Let her rip, Edgar.
That a baby.
Yes, sir.
Nice.
All right, Madison, it's your turn. Madison Nelson from the River Falls Swim Club. The River Falls Swim Club is volunteering in the concession stand tonight, and we sincerely appreciate their efforts. Let her rip, Madison.
Strike! Nice job, Madison.
Once again, another round of applause for Madison Nelson and Edgar Dittman.
There you go.
This ballpark was community built, and business donations were helped greatly by Johnny's Bar, and they've been a proud supporter of our ballpark and our community. Johnny's Bar has supported this ballpark from day one, and the tradition continues. At this time, will you please rise? Remove your hats and honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Ladies Fish Baseball here on River Falls Sports on the YouTube. Good evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm Kevin Westhouse. Glad you could join us tonight for Fish Baseball. The Hudson Raiders have traveled to town for a St. Croix Valley Baseball League game tonight. Love the rivalry. Hudson travels about 10.7 miles down the road here to River Falls, and it should be a dandy. Fighting Fish are 6-0 in the St. Croix Valley Baseball League. The Hudson River Rats are 3-5. They did have a couple early losses, and they have straightened it out since then. It should be a dandy tonight. Game time temperature tonight, 81 degrees. We have a wind out of the east-northeast at 7 miles an hour, kind of blowing in from center field a bit, and relative humidity is 54%. How do you spell glorious? That's what I'm going to say on this one tonight. It is beautiful this night tonight. Charlie Griffin on the mound tonight for the Fighting Fish, throwing to his battery mate, Andy Metcalf. Andy Metcalf, he's got a little Pert Plus in that flow again coming out the backside. It's looking good, isn't it, Greg? That flow he's got coming out the back. Fluffy. It's fluffy. Effervescent. Charlie Griffin. Chucky Bats, they call him. And he is getting loose. Hudson River Rats to start off the top of inning one. It'll be Nate Whitty, Sam Erickson, and Isaiah Grand-Korvitz. There's your first three. They throw it down, and we're ready to go. And Nate Whitty makes his way to the dish.
This center fielder, number 14, Nate Whitty.
Nate Whitty, center fielder for Hudson. And we are ready to go. 7:37, official first pitch game time tonight. Charlie Griffin. Right down Hanson Drive, and we're underway. Check swing. First base umpire says he did not go. It's now 1-1. One ball, one strike. Charlie Griffin stares into Andy Metcalf, has what he likes. Quick pitch. Ooh, like that there. That's a little quick pitch there. Just doesn't waste any time. I've seen that before, and that's tricky on a batter because everything's about timing and pace, and then he just gets up there and throws it in. I know the Raptor from the Brewers, he does that once in a while. He'll snap off a quick pitch on you when you're not ready, and works very often. Saw Charlie do it there. The 2-2, again, quick pitch. Jets away, now 3-2. They say vary the look, vary the move, vary the delivery. That's even trickier. Just missed, and a leadoff walk for Nate Whitty. So Whitty's on. We'll go now to Sam
now back
Erickson.
To the first baseman, number 3, Sam Erickson.
So I'm not sure how fast Whitty is. He's leadoff batter. We'll keep an eye on him. Interesting stance. Love it. That's hit pretty well in the center field. And caught back to first base. Let me get over here with that. Hold on. There we go. Nice job out in center field right there by Brian Giebel.
Number 15.
Giebel reigned. I thought that might drop in front of him, but he had to come in a couple steps. And it was a well-struck ball by Erickson. That's a line out to center. There's one down. Now we go to Isaiah Grand-Korvitz. Check the runner. Back in safely. Yeah, I kind of looked up, and I didn't know if it was going to drop in front of Giebel or not, but nice job kind of coming in a few steps and getting that. Nice lead out there, 4.5-step lead for Whitty. The pitch popped up again, headed towards the seats, and just out of play.
Just a reminder, please return all foul balls to the concession stand and receive some free candy.
Carter Elliott gave that a chase, just ran out of real estate. Up and out of play. Bounces out near the playground area in the Best Made Cookie batting cages. Check him again. Got him, says the field umpire. And not much argument from Nate Whitty. Picked off by Charlie Griffin. Two outs. I call that the old soft shoe, Greg. That's T for two. Two for T, ta-da-ta-ta-da-ta-ta-da-ta-ta, the crossover step, and you're out. A little softly hit right side. That's going to dunk in there for a two-out single by Isaiah Grand-Korvitz. Yeah, you can't do the crossover step. They'll get you, and Charlie Griffin recognized it, and bam.
It's time for the shortstop, number 19, Jack Erickson.
Jack Erickson will step in now with two out and a runner at first. High and tight, ball one. Two in the bucket. Nice block Runner does not go. And a real nice job back there by Metcalf getting big, keeping that ball in front of him and freezing the runner, Isaiah Grand Corbett, so couldn't go anywhere. That finds the corner. And a stolen base. A delayed steal by Isaiah Grand Corbett. He gets the stolen base. It's 2-1 now on Erickson on that called strike. Stolen base for Grand Corbett. Just delayed steal. Caught him on that. Weren't ready for it. And on down to second, he goes uncontested. Now a runner in scoring position with two outs. That's hit to the left side, and that's through. That might score a run. Let's see. Item picks it up. There comes the plate. And he'll score. Two out. RBI single for Jack Erickson. That's a big one for Hudson.
After the RBI single by Erickson, it brings up the right fielder, number four, Hunter Fry.
Hunter Fry now will make his way to the plate with two outs and a runner at first base. Yeah, nice piece of hitting there by Jack Erickson to plate the run with two outs. Two out RBI. High and tight, ball one. Charlie Griffin stares in. He checks the runner. Has what he likes. The pitch swings through that. It's now 1-1. One ball, one strike, two outs, one in here for Hudson in the top of inning one. Real nice two-out single by Isaiah Grand Corvitz, excuse me, Jack Erickson to score Isaiah Grand Corvitz. Chopper, too short, fielded and then gets away from the shortstop and on down to third goes the runner. That's going to be an error on Trey Larson over there at short. E6, bounce off of his glove. Now runners at the corners. Now runners at the corners for Hudson with two down.
Number 11, Jason Holler.
Now we go to Jason Holler with two outs and runners at the corners. Good opportunity again here for Jason Holler and the River Rats. That's high and tight, ball one. Flowing up and out of play. That is going to make the plaza area.
If the returning foul balls aren't holding up their end of the bargain, we'll sweeten the pot and the adults get a free beverage if they return a foul ball. Ooh. Get on your horse.
A buzz in the crowd. Let's see who the first 10-year-old is to get pushed down now, Greg. Flown up again and out of play. And we'll go stick at 1-2 on Jason Holler. Runners at the corners. There's one in for Hudson here in the top of inning one off the single off the bat of Jack Erickson, who now stands at third base. Charlie Griffin, he set at the belt. And here it comes. Flown up over the grandstand area. Now the adults are thinking about starting to chase those down. That created a pretty good buzz in the crowd. Greg Peters announced that foul balls returned by adults would be good for a beverage. Interesting. Stolen base for Hunter Fry. Ball in the dirt. Metcalf bobbled it a bit. And on down to second goes Hunter Fry. Now it's second and third with two outs. The 2-2 pitch flown up, and that one is also following out of play.
Jason Holler is going to run the Limey's Lodge dry tonight.
The 2-2, chopper foul. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Two on for Hudson. Runners at second and third with two outs. Great at bat here by Jason Holler. The pitch, that's high. Now 3-2. Jason Holler on for about an 8 or 9 pitch at bat right now. Battling up there. Got himself a good opportunity with runners at second and third. And he misses, and that's a two-out walk, and on down to first goes Jason Holler. Base is now loaded. We'll get to Mitch Lewis.
With the bases full of rats, it brings up the second baseman, number 2, Mitch Lewis.
Mitch Lewis now is in with bases full of river rats and two outs. Charlie Griffin pours one in there. It's 0-1. No balls and a strike, two outs. Swings through that, now it's 0-2. Fouled straight back and we'll stick at 0-2. Flipped away. And again, 0-2. Charlie Griffin from the windup. Here it comes. High and away. Couldn't get him to chase. We'll stick at 0-2. Hey, Greg, I've got the in-between inning song. That'll go with what you're talking about out here with the beers. Chug-a-lug. Flowing up on the infield. Trey Larson gathers and makes the catch. Hudson River Rats get one run on two hits, one error, and three left. After one half inning of play, 1-0. Hudson.
Grab a nice cold beverage from the Lining's Lodge and some great food from Twin Cities Pita. After tonight's game, head on down to Johnny's Bar for a little post-game party, River Falls Fighting Fish style. Leading off for the Fighting Fish in the bottom of the first inning, the center fielder, number 24, Brian Giebel.
Brian Giebel is in, hometown favorite, and we're ready to go here in the bottom of inning one. See if the fish can scrap and get that run back. Hammered to third. What a nice play over there at third base. Throws across. Got him. Wow, what a play over there by third baseman Will Jellick to rob Brian Giebel on a scorched ball to third base. Wow.
It's time for the shortstop, number 2, Trey Larson.
Now we're going to go to Trey Larson with one down. Will Jellick flashing the leather early over there at third base. Giebel just absolutely squares that up, scorches it, and gets robbed. Just boom. I say robbed as a Fish fan, but then as a Hudson River Rats fan, you go, hey, nice play. Will Jellick just like snapped him off. Boom. There's a strike now, 2-1 on Trey Larson. Trey Larson had a nice game last night. He had 3 hits. Real nice in a 12-0 win. That's a letter-high fastball. Now we go to 2-2. Owen Anderson on the mound, wearing number 29 tonight for the Hudson River Rats. That's flared into right. Get down, ball. No. Run down out there by right fielder Hunter Fry, covering some real estate, looking right into the teeth of the sun. Makes a nice play. And retires Mr. Trey Larson. 2 down. After that fly out to right, 2 down, we go to Ty Denzer. High and away, ball 1. Hello, Kim Bacon. Glad to have you. The 1-0. Right back up the box. And that is going to get through for a 2-out single by Ty Denzer. That was right back in your living room off the glove of Owen Anderson up into center field. 2-out single for Ty Denzer.
After the single by Denzer, it's time for the second baseman, number 3, Lucas Lutke.
Lucas Lutke. Speaking of a swinger last night, he drove one deep into the night. Ball gets away. And runner goes on down to second base with a hard round. Yeah, he scorched one last night. Right, that sign right there that says Home Run Alley, right over the top of that. It was absolutely K-rushed. It was a full loaf. There was absolutely no slice on it at all. There's a strike on the corner. Now it's 1-1 with 2 outs. Runner in scoring position for the Fighting Fish and Lucas Lutke. That's Ty Denzer standing out there. Anderson set. Here comes the 1-1 pitch. Back ankle breaker. Lucas says, I've seen that before. No sale. It's 2-1. That one also finds the corner, 2-2. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, 1 on. Here in the bottom of inning 1, 1-0. Hudson. The pitch to Lutke. Here it comes. Chopper. And just foul. First baseman Sam Erickson comes up and fields that about 4 feet into foul territory. And we'll stick at 2-2. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Foul, and now it heads towards the Fish dugout. Owen Anderson set. We'll do the 2-2 again. Here it comes. High gas, and he got him. Climbed the ladder on Lucas Lutke, and Owen Anderson wins that battle. And that will do it for the Fish here in inning number 1. They get no runs on 1 hit, no errors, and 1 left. We've played 1 here at First National Bank of River Falls Field. It is the Hudson River Rats 1, the Fighting Fish nothing. So how's everybody doing tonight? Looks like a great St. Croix Valley Baseball League matchup tonight on a glorious summer evening here in River Falls. All is well. Glad to have you along. Looking for some fun time tonight here at the ballpark. Go ahead and use the chat box. Let us know where you're watching from, listening from. Jeff from Sarasota, Florida, has held the traveling trophy for the farthest viewer and listener we've had last couple weeks. So it's a traveling trophy, and Jeff Phelan's got that right now down in Sarasota. Let's see if someone can beat that.
Leading off for the River Rats in the top of the second inning, the designated hitter, number 34, Joe Patterson.
Patterson, designated hitter, is in. Looks at a ball. It's 1-0. We're at the eighth spot in the order. Will Jellick waits on deck. Then we're going to go back to the top of the order to Nate Whitty. Hammered left side. Gathered. And nice job over there by first baseman Spencer Diedrich. Field it and then step on his own sack over there to get Joe Patterson for out number one.
Now batting the third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
Will Jellick now in the nine hole. Third baseman steps in. Made a dandy play over there against Brian Giebel in the top of the first. Giebel hit a rocket over to him at third base, and he just casually scooped that thing. Had the exit velocity of 98, and he said, "Hey, that's no problem." Boom. And threw Giebel out by 22 steps. That's how hard it was hit. Yeah, Giebel barely got out of the box. It was boom, boom, you're out. 0-2 now to Jellick. 58-footer hops in there. That's low, 1-2. Boy, real nice crowd filling in here tonight at First National Bank of River Falls Field. Nice crowd last night as well. You can see a lot of not many empty seats fouled away. That's up and out of play, and we'll stick at 1-2. Why wouldn't you come out, though? 81 degrees, 54% relative humidity. The wind is blowing straight down right now, so it's beautiful. It's calm. That's right back up through the box, and a solid one-out single for Will Jellick.
Will Jellick doing it in the field and at the plate. Now batting for the River Rats, the center fielder, number 14. Nate Whitty.
I'm going to go back to Nate Whitty. Nate walked and then picked off in the first. One down, one on. Good, nice lead out there by Whitty. That's away, ball one. Welcome, Terry and Kim Bacon, watching from Lake City, Minnesota. It's Maddie Bacon's parents. Glad to have you aboard. Always good to have the parentals on. Popped up right side, second baseman over, battling the sun, and makes the play. Nice job, Lucas Ludke, covering some real estate for out number two. Yeah, that sun's tough. You can see him
now
looking right
baseman,
into that.
Number three, Sam Erickson.
Now with two down, after the fly out to second, we go to Sam Erickson. Sam lined out to center his first time up. He hit a shot, and Brian Giebel played it well in center. Looks at a strike. There's your runner at first. That's down. Ball gets away. And alertly, Will Jellick will scamper on down to second. And I thank you very much. Wow. Hey, baby Christian, thank you, man. One and one, the pitch. Almost got him to chase, and Erickson lays off of that. It's now 2-1. So that's Will Jellick in your foreground. Got himself a one-out single, and now advances on a pass ball. Hammered, that's through on the left side, and just like the first inning, they get the two-out single and plate a run. And how about that hitting with two outs for the Hudson River Rats? That's two out RBIs in two innings in a row. solid for Huddy. And they jump out to an early 2-0 lead. Nice work. Nice hitting.
Now batting the catcher.
Exact same place, too. Nothing fancy. Just hit it hard right between the third baseman and the shortstop and plate the run. Popped up. And that is also going to reach the seats just in front of the Winey's Lodge in the plaza area. Look at the crowd filtering in tonight. It's a buzz here at the stadium. That was delivered a summer shandy. A great lemonade taste in the Lennon Kugel's product. Pretty good. That's flowing up. Coming hard is Giebel. Still coming. And I think that's caught by the right fielder, Ty Denzer, actually. I believe I was looking at my viewfinder here, so I think Denzer
Johnny
caught
Carr
that. He did, right fielder.
From nearly world-famous margaritas to live.
Nice job by Denzer calling off his center fielder. He had the line
Johnny
on that. And
Isaiah
Grand Corbett flies out to
ball.
Right field for out number three. But the Hudson River has to play another run. They get one run on two hits, no errors, and one left. After an inning and a half of play, it's still, well, it is now Hudson 2, Fish nothing. Looking ahead to the Fighting Fish, bottom of the second, it's going to be 5, 6, and 7. Diedrich, Metcalf, and Elliott.
Leading off the bottom of the second inning for the Fish, the first baseman, number 28, Spencer Diedrich.
Spencer Diedrich is in, the first baseman for the Fighting Fish. And we're ready to go here in the bottom of inning two. See if the Fish can scratch back, get one of those runs back. Diedrich hits it to the third baseman. Gathered, nice play, throws a cause and dug out. Big time play on both ends of that right there. Wow, really nice. Will Jellick knocks it down at third base, and what a scoop by Sam Erickson over there at first base to get Spencer Diedrich. Wow.
Now batting the catcher, number 25, Andy Metcalf.
Now we're going to Andy Metcalf. That's high. Yeah, quite a play. I thought that was going to get through between the third baseman and shortstop, and Will Jellick lays out, knocks it down, gathers himself, throws it across, it kind of in the dirt. But then Sam Erickson with a fine major league scoop over there. Nice. 1-1 now. Softly hit in front of the plate and foul. One ball, one strike on catcher Andy Metcalf. Looking to scratch and claw his way on here. High gas. Well, I guess the count was 1-2, and that got him. So climbs the ladder, does Owen Anderson on Metcalf, and gets him on a swinging third strike. Two down. Now we're going to go to Carter Elliott.
Next up for the Fish, the third baseman, number 13, Carter Elliott.
So quickly, two down here in the bottom of inning two, and Owen Anderson looking strong on the mound, and he's helped out by his great defense behind him. Starts him out with a breaker that slides across there, and it is 0-1. No balls and a strike on Carter Elliott. Smoke down the first baseline. That's about 8 feet foul. The 0-2 pours a fastball in at the knees on the corner right there, really close, just misses. Now it goes to 1-2. The pitch. That's way out of the zone, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Trevor Gutting waits on deck for the Fish. The 2-2. That was a protect swing there. Gets a piece of it, and Mr. Carter Elliott will live for another pitch. The 2-2, again, same thing, just wide of the first base bag. That time by about 5 feet, tried to shoot it down the line, just foul, and we'll stick at 2-2, and we'll do 2-2 one more time. Owen Anderson toes the rubber, stares into his battery mate, Isaiah Grand Corbett, works quickly, chopper to short, gathered on to first, got him by a step. Nice play by Jack Erickson at short to retire Carter Elliott for out number three. Fighting Fish in the bottom of the second. Go three up, three down. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. Two in the books now. It's 2-0 River Rats.
But the team does still have bills to pay, including the umpires for tonight's game. That's right. So throw a couple bucks in the hat if you can, and thanks for helping us keep playing Fighting Fish Baseball here at First National Bank of River Falls Field.
If you're looking ahead to the Hudson River Rats, top of the third, it's going to be 4, 5, and 6. Erickson, Fry, and Holler. Boy, I could do a Leinenkugel Summer Shandy commercial right now. Jack Erickson makes his way to the plate here in the top of inning three for the Hudson River Rats.
In the top of the third inning, the shortstop number 19, Jack Erickson.
So Jack Erickson is in. Hudson with a 2-0 lead and a couple two-out RBIs. Hit out to short. Trey out, and nice catch by Trey Larson out in short left center field. He has to range back and then makes a nice play. One pitch, one out.
Right fielder number 4, Hunter Fry.
We're going to go to Hunter Fry with one out. This one does have a clean top. And Jeff, I already announced that you have the traveling trophy from our farthest fan down there in Sarasota, Florida. So if you can beat Sarasota, Jeff will mail you the traveling trophy. But right now he holds it. He's got the traveling trophy for our farthest fan. A few people have kind of flirted with that, but he's got it right now. Sarasota, beat that, and Jeff will send you the traveling trophy. Leinenkugel, Summer Shandy. It's cool. It's got the lemonade refreshing taste. Three and one now on Hunter Fry. Hunter reached on an error his first time up. The 3-1 from Griffin. That's a strike. Now it's 3-2. Worked the count full. See if Chucky Batts, Charlie Griffin, can work all the way back here. Works quickly. Here it comes. Hit the short. Gathered. Larson on to first. Got him. Nice play. Trey Larson getting the job done out there at shortstop. Two down. And with two outs, we're going to go to Jason Holler. Walked his first time up.
Next up for the River Rats, the left fielder, number 11, Jason Holler.
Beautiful night at the ballpark. 81 degrees, summer, July 1, 2021. Awesome. Nary a breeze right now. It is summer. Not that humid, just nice. That just misses. Now 2-0 to Jason Holler, the left fielder for the Hudson River Rats. Hudson has jumped out to an early 2-0 lead on two out RBI singles, one in the first inning and one in the second inning. Clutch hitting. The 2-1. That finds the corner. Now 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Charlie Griffin, wearing number 19, stares into his battery mate, Andy Metcalf. Rocks, and here it comes. Foul. What did that hit? See what Griffin decides to do here. See if he tries to climb the ladder on Jason Holler or maybe work something on the back ankle here. Let's see. Works him outside. Misses. It's now 3-2. Three balls and two strikes. There's two outs. Should Holler reach, Mitch Lewis waits on deck for the Hudson River Rats. Griffin delivers. Missed him. And two-out walk for Jason Holler.
Now batting, the second baseman, number 2, Mitch Lewis.
Mitch Lewis does a little gardening on the AstroTurf. I think it's all good. And we're set to go. There's your runner with a really safe lead. High, ball one. If I was a betting man, I would say Jason Holler doesn't look like he's going anywhere. That's a two-step lead. Three-step, maybe, two and a half. Fouled up and out of play. It's 1-1. One ball, one strike. Two outs, runner at first. Both of Hudson's runs have come with two outs on clutch, two-out RBI singles. .58 hops in there. Nice job by Metcalf to block that. It's 2-1. Lewis pounds the plate. Runners out to his lead. Griffin set the pitch. Just misses inside. Now 3-1. Should Mitch Lewis reach, Joe Patterson is on deck. There's a strike, letter high, now 3-2. Once again, Griffin works the count full. Or does Mitch Lewis work the count full? The count is full. Runner will be going with the pitch. Chopper. Trey. Throws across and gets a nice job there by Trey Larson to get the third out of the inning on a high chopper. In the infield and retire Mitch Lewis. 6-3 if you're scoring along at home.
And are reasonably priced. Check out their website for more details at riverfallsswimclub.org.
The Hudson River Rats getting no runs on no hits, no errors, and one left. 2.5 in the books here from First National Bank of River Falls Field. 2-0 Hudson.
Stand tips go directly to the River Falls Swim Club.
Real nice crowd again tonight. This is rivaling last night's crowd. We estimated 650 to 700 last night, but we got them all the way down the line there. The plaza's pretty full, and the grandstands are 90% full. It's just a real nice crowd here on a Thursday night in River Falls, Wisconsin. 8-9-1 due up for River Falls. Anderson, he's got a fresh arm for the Hudson River Rats. We have to get the jugs gun on him here this inning. He's ready. And Trevor Gutting, Mr. Tag Nutrition, makes his way to the plate. If you want to get in shape and get your mind right around nutrition and health, call this guy. Trevor Gutting. Yeah, he'll help you get your mind right, your body right, and he's the guy. He's got his body fat down about 4.3%. He is lean. That misses. Now 2-0 to designated hitter Trevor Gutting. If you get your body fat under 5%, you work yourself into the starting lineup. That's in there, now 2-1. 2-1. The pitch, check swing, didn't bite on that slider. It's now 3-1. Nice hit bat here by Trevor Gutting to lead off the bottom of the third. Woo, just found the corner. You can check your K-zone at home. That might have been just off the plate, but called a strike by the home plate umpire. Counts full. Chopper to second. Gathered. On to first. Got him. And Trevor Gutting grounds out to second for out number one.
Now batting the left fielder, number 7, Josh. Item.
Now with one out, we're going to go to left fielder Josh Item. Item in with one out. Pretty well struck ball by Trevor Gutting. A nice play over there at second base by Mitch Lewis. There's the ball. After Item, we go back to the top of the order to Brian Giebel. That's down 2-0. Fish batters being patient and making Owen Anderson throw. Strikes. Fastball to belt. That's 3-1. Jugs Gun had that one at 84. 2-1 now to left fielder. Mr. Josh Item, and he looks at that one away. Now it's 3-1. Anyway, huh? Fish down by a pair. And Item gets himself a one-out walk, and he is on.
With one on and one out, it's time for number 24 in your program, number one in your hearts, Brian Giebel.
We go to Brian Giebel now with one down. Last time up, he absolutely scorched one to third base, and Will Jellick made one heck of a play over there. Giebel trying to tie it up with that swing. Fouls it straight back. It's 0-1. The 0-1 to Giebs. That's pit pretty well into center field. Center fielder going back. He's on his horse. And, he catches it right at the warning track. Wow. Giebel put a juice into that. He hit that 367.
Giebel gave it a ride, but it's out number two.
And what a nice play out there by center fielder Nate Whitty.
The
Hudson River Rats have brought their defense today. Boy, Whitty had to get on his horse to run that down, and right at the warning track at the base of the fence gets Giebel on a long flyout. So Giebel hitting the ball hard today, and he's got 2 outs to show for it. Two down, and now we're at Trey Larson, who looks at a strike. See if Trey can get something going here and get one in the gap with 2 outs. That misses inside. Josh Item over there at first base. There he is. Got himself a 1-out walk. See if Trey Larson can move him around here with 2 outs. Trey waves the bat. That hit him. He's not happy. Not happy. And on down to first he goes.
Now batting the right fielder, number 10, Ty Denzer.
Now with two on and 2 outs, we go to Ty Denzer. Denzer, 1-for-1 today. Could use one here. Get this thing, fish within one. I don't want to get greedy. Maybe hit one over the double-decker fence out there and right, but I'd take it. I'd take it. How about just get one through? Looks at a strike, now 1-1. One ball, one strike, two on for the fish. There they are. The 1-1 pitch. That just finds a corner, and Ty Denzer gives the old side eye to the catcher. It's 1-2. He gave the side eye to the umpire, I should say. Probably to the catcher, too, since the catcher's right in front of the umpire. And now Owen Anderson will step off and regroup. One ball, two strikes, 2 outs, 2 on. Anderson against Denzer. The pitch to Ty Denzer, here it comes. Got him on some high gas, and Owen Anderson has it dialed in tonight.
Local River Falls trivia brought to you by Johnny's Bar. Johnny's Bar opened in 1946, the same year Major League Baseball's defenses first invented the shift. Cleveland manager Lou Boudreau put 6 players on the right side of the field to try and slow down what hitter in 1946? Was it A, Joe DiMaggio, C, Babe Ruth, C, Ted Williams, or D, Mickey Mantle? If you guess C, Ted Williams, then you are correct.
Wow. Ted Williams, the first guy to get the shift against him.
American League title against Cleveland in September of 1946 with, you guessed it, an inside-the-park home run to left field when the Williams shift was on. Williams won the American League MVP in 1946, the same year Johnny's Bar opened their doors.
There you go. There you have it.
Leading off the top of the fourth inning for the River Rats, the designated hitter, number 34, Joe Patterson.
Joe Patterson is in. Grounded out to the first baseman, his first time up tonight. Looks at a ball down low off the arm of Charlie Griffin. That hit him. And on down to first goes Joe Patterson, lead off the fourth.
Yeah. Now batting, the third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
Will Jellick is in now. Will singled and scored his first time up tonight. Looks at a ball away. One and one now on third baseman Will Jellick, who's made some real nice plays defensively at third base for Hudson thus far. Check swing, that's just down now, 2-1. Little breeze kicking up now, got him out of the east northeast, blowing right in our face, right in from center field, 3 to 5 miles an hour. That's high. 3-1. Yeah, you'll see this camera here started getting a little fuzz on it. When it gets dark and the damp, it just goes away. So we're going to enjoy it while we can. The 3-1, that's a strike, and Jellick's going to have to come back. And we'll do it again. Full count now. A lot of full counts on these River Rats, being patient at the plate. The pitch. And this time Jellick says, I'm walking. That's down and away. After hit by pitch and a walk, Hudson's got two on and nobody out, and they are in a bit of business going back to the top of the order. We're going to Nate Whitty.
Now batting, the center fielder, number 14, Nate Whitty.
There's your River Rats, first and second, nobody out. Bunt situation here. I'm going to give you this shot just so we can watch this bunt. Assuming leadoff batter gets it down and foul. Yeah, I talk about this all the time. First and second, nobody out in a bunt situation. This is extremely difficult to defend. And even there, I mean, Charlie Griffin didn't get off the mound too fast. Third baseman stayed back. If that's fair, I don't know who's going to get him out. I mean, Metcalf's quick, but he's got to run down there and get that baseball. Now it looks like wheel play, maybe, swinging away. Looks at a strike, now it's 0-2, and now the bunt is going to be off, most likely, for leadoff batter Nate Whitty with two on and nobody out. See if Charlie Griffin and the Fish can drop a double play ball here. The pitch, check swing, just missed on that slider. It's 1-2, couldn't quite get him to chase. Nice pitch by Griffin at 0-2. How about roll one over here to third or short? The pitch flipped up in the foul territory, right side, and just out of play into the second row over there. Good hustle by first baseman Spencer Diedrich, just couldn't get to it. The 1-2, fouled straight back, and it'll stick at 1-2. Good, healthy hack there. Hey, welcome aboard, everybody. We're enjoying a good St. Croix Valley Baseball League game between the River Falls Fighting Fish and the Hudson River Rats. We've got a dandy brewing up here. Another one fouled straight back, and we'll stick at 1-2. Strikeout would be big, too. But Nate Whitty battling against Charlie Griffin, who delivers. Another foul. What an at-bat. Tell you what, these River Rats are making Charlie Griffin throw a lot of pitches here in the early going. 81 pitches already for Griffin. Wow. Wow. Hammered to third. That's passed the third baseman and on into left field. And here comes the runner around third, Joe Patterson, and he will score. Nate Whitty hits a screamer right past third baseman Carter Elliott over there at third and plates another run for Hudson.
By Whitty. It's time for the first baseman, number 3, Sam Erickson.
Sam Erickson now is in. He is 1-for-2 tonight. Nice piece of hitting. Flowing up. Giebel hustling over. Makes the catch. And nice job to hold the runner. So after that fly out to center, we got one down.
Number 15, Isaiah Grant-Corbett.
Isaiah Grant-Corbett now is in. He's 1-for-2 with a run scored today. Runners at first and second for Hudson. There they are, out to their leads. Grant-Corbett flies one up right side. Right fielder moving over and makes the catch. And no tag. Nice job out there in right field by Ty Denzer. He had to cruise over maybe 7-10 steps towards the line, makes
now
the catch, and
the
holds the runner.
19, Jack Erickson.
Now we're going to go to Jack Erickson with two down after that fly out to right. Two down. Erickson 1-for-2 today. One for two is Erickson. He's got a chance here with two outs again, and hammers one into left field, and that is down, and another, looks like another two-out RBI. Third two-out RBI of the game for Hudson. Erickson with a solid single into left, and plates Will Jellick. And Hudson jumps out to a 4-0 lead.
After the broken bat RBI single, it's time for the right fielder, number 4, Hunter Fry.
Hunter Fry is in now with two outs. Hunter has reached on an error and grounded out today. Ball inside. Runners at first and second for Hudson. There's two down. They have plated a pair here in the fourth to go up 4-0. The one ball pitch hit hard. Nice job by the third baseman. Steps on his own sack over there at third. Nice job over there by Carter Elliott.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny's Bar has live comedy shows, but you know what's no laughing matter is picking up trash. Remember, fans, this ballpark was volunteer.
Hudson River Rats get two runs on two hits, no errors, and two left. After 3.5, it's Hudson 4, River Falls nothing.
And throw your trash in the trash cans located all over the ballpark. If you're chewing sunflower seeds, put them in a cup and throw those bad boys away as well. This ballpark is a total team effort, and we appreciate your help. This trash timeout brought to you by Johnny's Bar. Check out their comedy club schedule at johnnysbar.com.
I see a Brian Senorowski in the crowd over there. I see him down there behind the dugout.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a special treat tonight. Brian J. Senorowski has just entered the building. Once again, Brian J. Senorowski has just entered the building.
There he is. There he is, Brian J. Senorowski. Here we go. Bottom of the fourth, Lucas Lukey is going to lead off.
Leading off the fish in the bottom of the fourth inning, the second baseman, number 3, Lucas Lukey.
Lucas Lukey leads off here for the fish in the bottom of the fourth, down by 4. Hammered into center field, center fielder drifting. He's got plenty of room and makes the catch for out number 1, Nate Witte. Kind of cruises under that and makes the catch and retires Lukey, one pitch, one out. Didn't quite get all of that. Or is he, Luke USA, just
next
missed
up
it.
For the Fighting Fish, the first baseman, number 28, Spencer Diedrich.
Now after Lidke, we go to Spencer Diedrich. Spencer grounded out to third, his first time up. One down now, Diedrich. Ball one. Little fuzz growing on this shot. We got it for about one more inning, and then we're going to say good night to this shot. Hammered into left, and whoo, baby, Spencer Diedrich with an absolute seed into left field for a one-out single. Nice piece of hitting right there by Spencer Diedrich.
It's time for the catcher, number 25, Andy Metcalf.
Let's see if Metcalf can move him around. That's a letter high fastball. 0-1. Nice lead out there by Diedrich. Fouled away. 0-2 now. The 0-2 pitch to Andy Metcalf. Here it comes. Just missed down. Good eye. It's 1-2. Owen Anderson in good control tonight. The 0-2 just gets a piece, and Metcalf will live for another pitch. There's one down here in the bottom of the fourth. Ludke flew out to center. Fish trying to put a quarter in the merry-go-round. He lays off that high gas. It's now 2-2. Spencer Diedrich absolutely scorched one into left field. He's still over there at first. And gets Metcalf on a little wrinkle. There's now two down. Took a little off of that.
Next up for the
pitch. Had Metcalf off balance.
The third baseman, number 13, Carter Elliott.
Now we're going to Carter Elliott with two down and a runner at first base. Let's see if Carter can keep this thing going, huh? It's hit well into right, but foul. 17 rows back down the right field line and out of play. It's 0-1. Here with two outs in the bottom of the fourth, Hudson 4, Fighting Fish nothing. Hudson with four runs on six hits, the Fish with no runs on two hits and one error. Owen Anderson set, and here it comes. Just down, 1-1. Carter Elliott, third baseman, grounded out to short his first time up, trying to keep her going here for the Fish. Foul that one away as well. It's now 1-2. The 1-2 hit through on the right side, and that is through for a two-out single. Nice piece of hitting right there by Carter Elliott. And there are now two on for the Fish, and we're going to go to Trevor Gutting. Nice piece of hitting there. Nice at bat by Carter Elliott. Saw a lot of pitches and then took something on the outside half of the plate and drove it through the infield. Yeah, we're done with that. Look at that. That got fuzzy quick. Look at that. No, well, no bueno, maybe. Stick with it just for T-Gut. High. 2-0 now on Trevor Gutting. Trevor grounded out to second his first time up. Great two-out RBI opportunity here for designated hitter Trevor Gutting. Mr. Tag Performance. That's away now 3-0. Should Gutting reach, Josh Item waits on deck. The 3-0. That one finds the corner. Now it's 3-1. A couple runners out there for a fish on a couple singles. Walked him. And Trevor Gutting gets himself a two-out walk, and the live well is full here at First National Bank at River Falls Field. Fish
with
on every
live
base.
Live well full of fish. It's time for the left fielder, number 7, Josh Item.
Josh Item now with a great opportunity with two in the bucket. Get the fish on the board here. Not before a conference on the mound. Isaiah Grand Corbett. Corbett is going to go out and have a quick chat with Owen Anderson. Nancy Faust, the organist, wakes up here up in the booth. Pretty good atmosphere here at First National Bank at River Falls Field. I'm not going to lie to you. It's fun. There's one. Right there, it's 0-1 on Josh Item. I think I'm just going to go here. Save the headache. Ooh, nice job back there by Isaiah Grand Corbett. Saved a run like a cat. One ball, one strike now on Josh Item. Bases full of fish. The pitch. Item watches that. It's now 2-1. No place to put him. Brian Giebel waits on deck. I think he's going to get something to hit right here. Owen Anderson from the windup, and here it comes. Whew, that just finds the corner. A little murmur in the crowd. They didn't like it. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Here it comes. Check swing. Yes, he did, says home plate umpire. And down goes Item for out number 3.
The Council would like to say thanks to the River Falls Swim Club for volunteering in the concession stand tonight. They have training sessions available year-round and ages 4 to 18.
The Fighting Fish threaten in the bottom of inning 4. They end up getting
the concession stand.
No runs on two hits. There were no errors, and they left them loaded. After 4 complete now from First National Bank of River Falls Field, it is still Hudson 4, Fish nothing. We're going to the 5th. And that right there, my friend, is a summer shandy. New pitcher for the Fish, Matt Dornick. The line on Charlie Griffin, he gives up 4 runs on 6 hits. There was an error, so all 4 of those runs were not earned. Dornick is ready. And Andy Metcalf will throw her down.
Now pitching for the Fighting Fish, number 34, Matt Dornick. leading off for the River Rats.
6-7-8
due up. Top of the fifth inning. The left fielder, number 11, Jason Holla.
Jason Holler, he has walked twice tonight. Sixth spot in the order. Top of the fifth we go. 4-0, Hudson. Dornick delivers high and away, ball one. Still a lot of baseball left tonight. Maybe the fish can, someone can kick the bat rack. Took a little off of that, had him out in front. It's now 1-1 on Jason Holler. Like I said, Holler has reached twice tonight, both times via the free pass. The 1-1 just misses inside there. It's 2-1. Two balls and a strike on left fielder Jason Holler for the Hudson River Rats. Matt Dornick in relief of Charlie Griffin on the mound for the Fish. Throws that one past Holler. It's now 2-2. Mitch Lewis waits on deck. Dornick set, and here it comes. And nice job. Holler just gets a piece. He'll live for another pitch. Let's take a peek at this one. See, we'll leave it here for one pitch. Let's see. We can see him paint the corner. Dornick stares in, has what he likes. The 2-2. That's flown up into right field. Right fielder coming in, dives, and makes the catch. Oh, baby, Ty Denzer lays out and retires Jason Holler on a diving catch in short
after
right center field.
By Denzer.
Web gem, Ty Denzer.
Time for the second baseman, number 2, Mitch Lewis.
Nice play, Denzer. That's pretty fun. Went out. Now we go to Mitch Lewis after the fly out to right. One down, Mitch Lewis. Mitch is flown out to short and grounded out to short. Left that one upstairs. That's one of those, Matt Dornick. You just kind of tip your hat out there to Ty Denzer and right and go, hey, nice catch. One out. The pitch. 58-footer hops in there. It's 2-1. Lennon Kugel's Summer Shandy. That fresh lemonade, refreshing summer taste. The 2-1. High and tight, now 3-1. River Rats scored one in the first, one in the second, and two in the fourth. The 3-1. Dornick just misses there. And on down to first goes Mitch Lewis. And he is on with one out. And we're going
now
to
back,
Joe Patterson.
The designated hitter, number 34, Smoking Joe Patterson.
Patterson looks down and gets the signs. Dornick set. And here it comes. That's hit into center field, and that is going to get down right in that spot, right in where you can't see it. But you're going to have to trust me. Flip that into center field and hit 15 feet in front of center fielder Brian
After
Gibble.
Single
Solid
Patterson.
Single for Patterson.
It's time for the third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
Now we're going to third baseman Will Jellick. He's been on base twice. He's singled and scored. He's walked and scored. Nice job in the nine spot tonight for Will Jellick. He's gelling. Jellick. Gelling. One out. Just misses high and tight. 1-0. Maybe get him to roll over on one here. skips off the plate, 2-0. Should Jellick reach, we go back to the top of the order to Nate Whitty. Fouled away. Now it's 2-1. Charlie Behrens, the Manitowoc Minute guy, will be here at First National Bank of River Falls Field on September 9th, Thursday, September 9th. The Kenny River Land Trust is bringing him into town. I think there's almost 2,000 seats available, and many, many are sold. If you want to check that out, go to the runner goes down to third and stolen base. Now the ball gets away. And runners at second and third now with one out. 3-1 is the count. So go to Kenny River Land Trust's website, and you'll learn more about the Charlie Behrens, the Manitowoc Minute Guys event here that'll happen on Thursday, September 9th at 7:30 p.m. Looking forward to that. I've got my tickets, and I will be here. I'll bring my Keeper Moving license plates with me. Keeper Moving there, guy. Swings through that high fastball. It's now 3-2. Big out here. We got room for him, but then the bases will be loaded. We're going back to the top of the order. I'm sure Matt Dornick could like to put a lid on this right now. Missed and down. And on down to first goes Will Jellick, on for the third time tonight. Base is now full of River Rats.
It's time for the center fielder, number 14, Nate Whitty.
Nate Whitty's in. Base is loaded. One out. How about a comebacker here? Corners are in. Middle infield's a double play depth. That's a ball high and inside, 1-0. Yeah, corners are in. Well, kind of in. Middle's a double play depth. Two and oh. No place to put him now. Sam Erickson in on deck. 4-0. Hudson looking to add on to their lead here. High and tight, 3-0. There's one, 3-1. Three balls and a strike on Nate Whitty. The pitch, here it comes. Walked him and walked in a run to make it 5-0 now. Five nothing Hudson. Two spot in the order, Sam Erickson.
Now batting the first baseman, number 3, Sam Erickson.
Sam Erickson makes his way to the dish with the bases loaded. Sam is 1-for-3 tonight. Swings through that. It's 0-1. The 0-1 pitch from Dornick. Fouled away. Now it's 0-2, and Dornick works ahead. The 0-2, here it comes. Chopper, left side, third baseman just off his glove and on into left field. One run is in, two runs are in. And off the glove of third baseman Carter Elliott, they're gonna give the score that at E5. Two more runs for Hudson.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Isaiah Grant Corbett.
So after the two more runs, it'll make it 7-0 Hudson. We go to Isaiah Grant Corbett. It was a chance there for Carter Elliott. I think maybe he was thinking a little too quickly. Picked his head up, hit off the tip of his glove and on into left field, and two runs plated. And the batter, Sam Erickson, alertly then scampered down to second. So it's second and third, just one out for three-hole hitter Isaiah Grant Corvitz, who's 1-for-3 tonight with a single and a run scored and a stolen base. Look out, just missed him, 2-0. Looks like some activity now down in the Fish bullpen. Got a couple guys down there getting loose. 7-0, River Rats. Didn't see it coming. There's a strike, now 2-1. Two balls and a strike. Matt Dornick stares in. Isaiah Grant Corvitz waves the bat. Looks at a breaking ball and kind of fooled him. Dropped it in there. It's now 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Runners at second and third. Dornick set, and here it comes. 57-footer, and what a great block right there by Andy Metcalf. For you youngsters at home, watch Andy just square up there. Get the elbows in tight, square up, take it off the chest, and keep it in front of him. Great job, Andy Metcalf, behind the dish. It's now 3-2. Dornick delivers. Got him swinging. First base is unoccupied. Got to throw it on the first. Hit him in the head. And that's on into right field and disaster. Hit him right in the head. Yeah, he ran down there. He was in the running lane. And Metcalf was checking the runner at third, then threw it down to first and hit Grant Corbett's right in the back of the head, and the ball caromed on into right field, and he reaches.
Number 19, Jack Erickson.
Tough break there for Dornick and the Fish after he gets the strikeout. Another run plated for Hudson as well. Had a little catch up here. And still just one out. That one hurt. Popped up. Short center. Could be a tough play. Giebel. He's got it. And no tag. Giebel, nice play out there in center field to retire Jack Erickson on a fly to center for the second out. Finally,
next
two
up
outs.
For the River Rats, the left fielder, the right fielder, number 4, Hunter Fry.
Hunter Fry now in with two outs. Still second and third for Hudson. They've already plated 4 this inning. A couple errors and one hit. 3 walks. Low and away. 2-0. On Hunter Fry. The Hudson River Rats have batted around here in the fifth. That's Protractor down the right field line. It's 2-1. Yeah, Hudson's batted around. They've played it 4. They've got one hit. Like I said, 3 walks and 2 errors. It's not a good formula if you're a Fish fan. It's a formula for 4 runs if you're a Hudson fan. Ball gets away from the catcher. And might have a shot at him. Not going to get him. Wild pitch, another run scores. Alertly, Sam Erickson takes home. Now it's 9-0 Hudson. Like I said, I didn't see this bus coming. Coming through. Comes the Hudson River Rat Express. And another two-out walk. Now we go back to Jason Holler, who started this inning.
Now batting the left fielder, number 11, Jason Holler.
We go back to Jason Holler. Jason started this inning, flew out to right field on a diving catch. And a ball gets away, and another run scores, and another wild pitch. On down to second goes Holler. Grand Corbett scores. That's going to make it 10-0. Hudson. Yeah, that Hudson River Rats Express bus. Hold on. That Hudson River Rats Express bus coming through. Got the backup blinker on now because they're going to back over the fish. Beep, beep, beep. 10-0. Swings through that. Yeah, Greg, don't you think? Is he? Well, we talked a little bit about it. Let's get him on the air. Come on. Let's talk a little bit about it over here, Sinarski. Come on. 2-1 now on Jason Holler. That's down. Now 3-1. 3-1. Dornick set. The 3-1. Here it comes. 3-2. See if we can get him here. Should Holler reach, Mitch Lewis waits on deck. The pitch. Got him swinging. No one else can make an out, but Jason Holler made two outs that inning. I hate that when that happens.
Baseball trivia brought to you by
there you go. The
Johnny
Hudson
Clark.
River Rats score 6 runs on one hit. There were 2 errors and 1 left. After 4.5, it's Hudson 10, River Falls nothing.
5 other teams broke the 1 million mark for the first time as baseball's attendance doubled from the previous year. What was the reason for the 100% increase in attendance? Was it A, stadiums began selling beer? B, ticket prices were decreased? C, more teams were added? D, World War II was finally over, the best players were back in uniform, and people were dying to go watch baseball. If you guess D, then you are correct. Baseball trivia brought to you by Johnny's Bar. Reserve their back party room and bring your own food free of charge. Bringing food to Johnny's is allowed and encouraged.
Well, it's going to be the top of the order.
Leading off for the Fighting Fish, this center fielder, number 24, Ryan Gebo.
Top of the order for the Fish. Let's see if they can get it on here. Brian Gebo, see if he can get into one. Fish down by 10. You need base runners now. Look out, that's inside. Ball one. Owen Anderson's been lights out for Hudson. poured that one in there. Jugs Gunn had that one at 86. Good velocity on that. That's upstairs, though. 2-0. No, I'm good yet. I'm positive. Too much talking. How you doing, Mr. Garish? Good to see you. 3-0 now to Brian Giebel. There's one, now 3-1. Owen Anderson. Whew, calls a strike, and Giebel's going to have to come back. Didn't like it. Didn't like that at all. See if Owen Anderson can work all the way back here against tough-hitting Brian Giebel. The 3-2 got him on some high gas. Came up high and inside. That's going to be tough
next
to hit.
Next up for the fish, the shortstop, number two, Trey Larson.
Now we go to Trey Larson with one out here in the bottom of inning five. And tell you what, Owen Anderson's getting stronger as the game goes on. One or no? Now 2-0. He fell behind. Owen Anderson fell behind Brian Giebel 3-0 and worked all the way back to get the strikeout. Trey Larson flew out to right in a hit by a pitch today. That's high. Now 3-0 again. Look out, that hit him. Oh, he's mad. Trey Larson, not happy. Not happy. 3-0 plunked. Second time he's been hit by a pitch tonight by Owen Anderson, and I don't know if they got something going on or not, but Trey Larson, not pleased. Down 10-0. Now we're going to Ty Denzer with one out and a runner at first base. That's going to leave a mark. Got him in the hip area and probably just above where the meat is on your hip, kind of in the hip bone. And yeah, it's not going to feel good. And he wasn't happy. He threw his bat pretty hard. I'm not saying how hard, but I think it plummeted into planet Earth and is now just hitting the hot lava. Yeah, he let that thing go and was not happy. The 1-0, that's away, 2-0. So Owen Anderson has been pretty fine tonight, and here in the fifth, maybe lost it a little bit. Kind of a long inning, though, and sometimes pitchers' arms get a little stiff. We'll see how he reacts. 2-0 to Ty Denzer. Ty is 1-for-2, singled in the first, struck out in the third. That one finds the corner, now 2-1. Let's take a peek at this right here. Let's see what we got. Ooh, is that bad? Oh, my goodness. 2-1. Followed straight back. Now it's 2-2. Owen Anderson's got a pretty lively fastball, and as this game progresses, his arm almost seems to be getting stronger. Fresh, very fresh. Two balls, two strikes, one out, the pitch. That's away, now 3-2. Trey Larson over there at first base, he got plunked for the second time of the game and wasn't overly pleased. Runner goes, and that's a walk. And on down to first goes Ty Denzer. Hey, the fish got base runners. A couple of them with one out.
With two on. One out. It's time for the second baseman, number three, Lucas Lutke.
Going to Lucas Lutke. Tough hitter here, but not before a little conference on the mound.
The Fighting Fish would like to congratulate members of the 8th grade volleyball team that recently won a club national championship. Congrats, River Falls 8th grade girls. Good job.
All right. They're laughing. They're loose. They're up 10-0. They're like, let's throw strikes. But tough hitting. Lucas Ludke, second baseman, hit one almost up to the interstate yesterday. Let's see if he can get one in play here. Down 10. Just need to get one through. Nothing. Don't need to get greedy yet. Lucas 0 for 2 today. The pitch. That's a strike at the knees. It's 0-1. On second baseman, Lucas Ludke. Couple fish on the bases. That one paints the corner as well, and I think maybe the conference was, hey, let's just stick with the old number one. We're up 10-0. Let's try to hit the corners and see what happens. Owen Anderson, the 0-2 pitch to Ludke. Again, just sticks with old number one, throws some gas. It's fouled away, and we'll stick at 0-2. He was throwing like 83 to 84. I think he's hit the 86 mark here a couple times this inning. He's got a little something on it, a little something. Speaking of little something, right there he goes up top. Jugs Gun had that one at 86. Lucas Ludke swings through it. There are now two down. And we're going to go to Spencer Diedrich.
The first baseman, number 28, Spencer Diedrich.
Spencer Diedrich now with two in the bucket. Ball inside, 1-0, two down. Two on for the fish. Owen Anderson will step off. I think he wants to talk to his catcher. I don't know if this fish may be stealing signs or something. I don't know. Change up the indicator, making sure they're on the same page. I think they're on the same page now. One and oh to Diedrich. That just misses down. Now it's 2-0 to Spencer Diedrich. Andy Metcalf waits on deck should Diedrich find his way on. Owen Anderson delivers us away. Ball gets away from the catcher and the runners will advance to second and third. Now it's a great opportunity here for Spencer Diedrich. A 3-0 count and runners at second and third for the Fighting Fish. 3-0, Fish down by 10. And they're going to put Diedrich on to get to the catcher, Andy Metcalf. That is interesting. So they put Diedrich on. Live well is full again, and we're going to Andy Metcalf.
With the live well full of fish, it brings up the catcher, number 25, Andy Metcalf.
See if Metcalf can get her done, get the fish on the board. Woo! Healthy hack on some high gas. It's 0-1. Metcalf, he's got the flow coming out the back. The 0-1 pitch. Look out. That hit him, and the fish are on the board. Hey, you never know, right? You never know. 10-1.
Now batting the third baseman, number 13, Carter Elliott.
Elliott is 1 for 2 tonight. See if he can find a way here. Base is still loaded. And Owen Anderson will work from the windup. Misses outside, 1-0. Again, misses away, 2-0. Plenty of velocity, just missing. 96 pitches for Owen Anderson. He's getting up there, too. A little activity in the Hudson bullpen. We're still early. It's only the fifth. Fish down 10-1. That's hit through on the right side, and that's through. One run is in, and they'll go station to station. And nice two-out RBI single for Carter Elliott. Second hit of the game for Carter Elliott.
It brings up the designated hitter, number 21, Trevor Gutting.
Now they go to T-Gut with two outs and the bases still loaded. Live well, still full. Owen Anderson from the windup. Here it comes. Throws that one past him. It's 0-1. 10-2. Eighth batter of the inning. Josh Item waits on deck. Fish have played it two here in the bottom of the fifth. Finally took the lid off this thing. High gas, 86 on the jugs gun again. It's 1-2. The pitch. And this time Trevor times it and just gets a piece and he'll live for another one. It's 1-2. Fish all the way around the board. Live well full, 227-inch walleyes and a nice fat bass in there. He'll get a piece off the catcher's mitt, and once again, Trevor Gutting stays alive at 1-2. Seems like Owen Anderson's not messing around here, just throwing. Isaiah Grant Corbett is just throwing out old number one. He's rearing back and just firing again. Popped up on the infield, near side. And look out, that just reaches the seats. Just gets into the second row over here in the plaza area. Looks like everybody's okay. And we'll do it again. The 1-2, check swing. Yes, he did. And he got not happy.
Local music trivia,
and that will do it.
Johnny's Bar.
For the Fish here in the fifth.
Band is climbing the ranks on Spotify with their hit song.
Fish get two runs on one hit, no errors, and three left. Five in the books. 10-2. Hudson.
B, the Tommy Benz Band. C, the New Skinny. Or D, Brian Keeble and the Blowfish. If you guess C, the New Skinny, then you are correct. Here's your request and dedication. Keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for the stars.
Throw her down. Matt Dornick is good. And here we go, top of the sixth. 7-8-9, Lewis, Patterson, and Jellick.
Ooh. leading off for the River Rats, the second baseman, number 2, Mitch Lewis.
Mitch Lewis is in here in the top of the 6th. 7-8-9. Lewis looking for his first hit tonight. Officially 0 for 2 with a walk and a run scored. One ball and no strikes on second baseman Mitch Lewis. Look out. That hit him. And on down to first goes Lewis. Lead off hit by pitch. Few of those tonight. Let me go to Joe Patterson, the designated hitter.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 34, Joe Patterson.
Joe Patterson is 1-4-2, hit by a pitch, and 2 runs scored this evening. Popped up, foul and out of play. It's 0-1, and Matt Dornick works ahead.
Just a reminder, please return all foul balls to the concession stand and receive some free candy.
Free candy. If you return that baseball. That's high. 1-1 now. On 8-hole hitter, designated hitter, Joe Patterson. 10-2, Hudson. Top of the 6th. Runner goes. Fouled away at the plate, and we'll do it again. Pretty good jump there by Mitch Lewis, up 10-2. Says, I'm going to steal a base if you're going to give it to me. The 1-2. That's away. 2-2. Dornick set at the belt. The 2-2 pitch. Here it comes. That's down, now 3-2. Nobody out. Runner at first. Mitch Lewis was hit by a pitch to lead off this inning. Joe Patterson is in there now, looking to move him around. Fouled away. We'll do it again. Stick at that full count. Low and away. And that walk puts 2 on for the Hudson River
Next
Rats here
the
in the 6th.
The third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
Well, Will Jellick is up, 9-hole hitter, and he's having a real nice game. He's been on 3 times. He's 1-for-1, been on 3 times, and has scored 3 times. A little conference on the mound. Hey, Kayla Fuller, do I know if you'll be broadcasting on the July 11th?
I'd like to welcome Brielle Dusick, the First National Bank.
Possibly. I'm usually like day-to-day, but I don't think I have any plans on the 11th that I'm aware of. Well, actually, I do. I'm going to be in Chicago at my nephew's high school graduation, so I will probably not be here on July 11th. Sorry about that, Kayla. Yeah, I have to go to Chicago actually on Saturday the 10th and Sunday the 11th. I'll be traveling back from Chicago, so I probably won't be doing that game, Kayla. Sorry about that. What's up?
There's Kevin Westy.
One ball, one strike. Nobody out here in the top of inning 6 for the Hudson River Rats. Sorry, Kayla, I wish I would be, but I was thinking ahead. I usually don't have a lot going on, but that weekend we're going to Chicago. So, shoot, wish I was doing it. Sorry. The 1-2 fouled away, and we'll stick at 1-2. on Will Jelic. Again, singled and scored in the second, walked and scored in the fourth, walked and scored in the fifth. So bad, Kayla. I wish I would be here for that. Mm. That's hit towards short. Slow roller, Trey Larson. Quick throw to second for one. On to first. Won't get the double play, but they'll get the force at second and get the out. So Jelic will reach on a fielder's choice. We do get the 6-4 put out at second for the first out of the inning. And Mitch Lewis moves over to third. And there's runners at the corners now for Hudson.
Number 14. Nate,
runners at the corners, and we're going to back top of the order. Nate Witte, one down. High and tight, ball one. Fish down 10-2 to the Hudson River Rats, who are looking to tack on here. They have runners at the corners and just one out. Matt Dornick on the mound for the Fighting Fish. Fouled away at the plate. It's 1-1. So I like doing this stuff, and I love doing these games. It's a great way to hang out, but my priorities are if I got some family stuff going on, I want to hang out with the kids or whatever, I got to do it, and I just go do it. I'm not gonna cancel a lake trip on a Saturday to do this. And I can't cancel a high school graduation for a nephew to do this. So it's all volunteer and stuff, and I like doing it. And if I had all free time, I'd do every game, but it's high on my list, but it's not the top of my list. How about that? Hope that's understandable. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Dornick set and delivers. Throws a yacker and thought he had it. Just missed upstairs. It's 3-2. Sam Erickson waits on deck. Runners at the corners. There's one out. Popped up. And that is also going to reach the plaza area. And out of play. The 3-2 pitch, here it comes. Ooh, high and away. And the bases will be loaded.
Now batting the first baseman, number 3, Sam Erickson.
Sam Erickson now to the plate, hitting in the two-hole tonight, having a nice game. Flown to left and fairly deep. Left fielder is on it. Makes the catch. Runner will tag and score. A little late with that on the camera, but you have to trust me, flew that out to right field, left fielder Josh Item, and that's just a sack fly for out number 2. Goes down as F7, second out, sack fly, run scores.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Isaiah Grand-Corvitz.
Now we go to Isaiah Grand-Corvitz with 2 down and runners at first and second. First and second for Hudson with 2 down. They've got 1 in here this inning to make it 11-2. Looking to add on. They've really had a lot of luck today with 2 outs getting runners in. That's just down now, 1-1. 1 ball, 1 strike on Isaiah Grand-Corvitz, the catcher for Hudson, hitting in the 3-hole tonight. One for four, two runs scored. Look out! Just about hit him. Now it's 2-1. Should Grant Corvitz reach here, Jack Erickson waits on deck. Last at bat, Grant Corvitz struck out. The ball got away from the catcher. And then when the catcher threw it down, hit off the back of his helmet and on into right field, and he reached and ended up scoring. Swings at that slider. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Matt Dornick set and delivers. Popped up. Center fielder Giebel camped under it, and now he loses it. It's in the lights, bounces over his head, and a run will score. Lost that one. Giebel just lost it. And
next up for the River Rats, the shortstop, number 19, Jack Erickson.
Did you score that? Did he score that a hit or an error? Hit. Base hit. Didn't touch it. Runner goes down and he's in. Had score that a base hit. Let me get this going here. We got another run. A little housekeeping. 12-2 now. That one's going to leave a mark. Runners at first and second now. Two outs. Jack Erickson. Oh, yeah. He wants. I don't know if it'll go. Let me see. Try it. I'm on a Galaxy. Sorry. Look out. That gets past him and on down to third now. Goes Grant Corvitz. Actually, two runs scored on that. It's 13-2. They were hustling. So two runs scored on that pop-up. 13-2. High strike. 2-2. It's going to leave a mark. Giebel must have flat lost that one in the lights. The 2-2 pitch, hammered foul. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, three in here for Hudson in the sixth. The pitch. Look out, that's high. Now 3-2. Popped up. Trey Larson calling, and we'll make the catch right behind the third base bag for out
Ladies
number
and
three.
Music trivia brought to you by none other than Johnny's Bar. In 1981,
Hudson River Rats scored three runs on one hit.
Reached number two on the Billboard chart.
There might have been an error in there and one left. After five and a half, 13-2, Hudson.
A, Cheryl. B, Judith. C, Jill. Or D, Connie.
Connie.
If you guess B, Judith, then you are correct. Speaking of juice, you will receive freshly squeezed juice and the nearly world-famous margaritas right down at Johnny's Bar in downtown River Falls.
New chucker for Hudson. Max Elliott is in on the mound for Hudson. So Max Elliott is in. For Owen Anderson.
Hey, Greg. Hey,
Working with a public address announcer.
Now pitching for the River Rats, number 18, Max Elliott.
Josh Item makes his way to the plate.
Leading off for the Fighting Fish in the bottom of the sixth inning. The left fielder, number 7, Josh Item.
With a 9 spot in the order, see if Item can work his way on. Fish down by 11. Here we go, bottom of the sixth. I don't know. Item walked and struck out today, 0 for 1 officially. That's down ball 1 off the arm of Max Elliott, who's in relief of Owen Anderson. Maybe the Fish can get his number here. There's a strike. Check swing. No, he did not. Chopper right back through the middle. Get through there, ball. Yes. And nice job by Item with an infield single for Josh Item to lead off the sixth inning. Nice piece of hitting.
After the single by Item, it brings up the center fielder, number 24, Ryan Giebel.
Now we go back to the top of the order to Brian Giebel. Nice job by Josh Item finding his way on here, down by 11. There's a strike. It's now 1-1. Giebel looking for his first hit tonight. Max Elliott delivers. That's just down, now 2-1. Fouled straight back. Hammered through on the right side. Brian Giebel with a single. Back-to-back singles for the Fish here in the sixth, and they're in a bit of business against the new pitcher, Max Elliott.
Now batting the shortstop, number 2, Trey Larson.
So Giebel with a solid single through on the right side. Now we go to Trey Larson. He's been hit by a pitch the last two times up, but he's not been happy about it. Ball and a strike now on shortstop, Trey Larson. One ball, one strike. Swings through that high gas. It's now 1-2. Trey's got to be happy. He didn't get plunked here yet. He's been on twice tonight. He's officially 0 for 1, but had been on twice and scored once. Hit by a pitch twice. That's flipped into right field. Get on, ball. Fair ball down into the corner. around third. Here comes Item, making his way home. And now we got another runner coming home. Nice work, Brian Gable. Larson says, coming through. I'm going for a triple. I don't know what you're doing standing here. I'm coming for three. And Gable says, all right, I'll go home too. Two-run triple for Brian Gable. Two-run triple by Trey Larson.
It brings up the right fielder, number 10, Ty Denzer.
Ty Denzer now in after that bases-clearing triple off the bat of Trey Larson. He says, there, don't hit me, I'll hit a triple. Two RBI, triple. Hey, a lot of baseball to be played. Bats are coming alive, new pitcher in Max Elliott. Fisher all over him like a pack of dogs on a three-legged cat here in the sixth. Gets away, and we're going to play another one. Yes, we are. And the Fish are in business. Bases are cleared now. There's still nobody out here in the sixth. The Fish have three runs on three hits against Max Elliott. Chopper to second. Gathered on to first. Scooped out over there by Sam Erickson at first base to retire Ty Denzer on a pretty well-hit ball. That goes 4-3, one out.
Next up for the Fish, the second baseman, number 3, Lucas Lutke.
It's not going to get any easier for Max Elliott. We send the four-hole hitter, Lucas Lutke, to the dish here. Lutke waves the bat. Elliott rocks and delivers. That finds the corner, 0-1. Fouled straight up over the grandstand area, and Elliott works ahead of Lutke, 0-2. .56 bounces in there. It's 1-2 now. Get you a little tighter on this. The pitch fouled away. And we'll stick at 1-2. Max Elliott in relief of Owen Anderson's come in here in the sixth inning. The Fish have kind of beat him up a little bit. Three runs on three hits to make it 13-5 in a little bit of a ball game here in the middle innings. It's 2-2 now against tough-hitting Lucas Lutke. The pitch. That skips in there. It's now 3-2. Spencer Diedrich wakes on deck for the Fighting Fish. The pitch fouled away and not held onto by catcher Isaiah Grankorvitz, and it'll stick at 3-2. Hi. And on down to first goes Lucas Lutke.
With one on and one out. It brings up the first baseman, number 28, Spencer Diedrich.
So Spencer Diedrich now with one on and one out, trying to keep this inning. Trying to put another 50-cent piece in the merry-go-round here. I'll play a couple more here in the sixth and really make this game interesting. A lot of baseball to be played yet here tonight at First National Bank of River Falls Field. Spencer Diedrich's got himself a hit. He's 1-for-2 with a walk. Runner goes, and he has got that stolen easily. Stole it on the pitcher. Took off on first move, and on down to second goes Lucas Lutke. That's a wily veteran move there. Stolen base for Lutke. flown into right. Right fielder's going to have to give a chase. If that's fair, it's trouble. Just foul. Just foul. Yeah, the right fielder was shaded towards right center. Flipped that down into the right field corner. If that was fair, he could run all day. About 4 feet foul. Close. The 1-2. Nice catch back there by Grant Corbett. It's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Runner at second for the Fish. They've plated three here in the sixth to make it 13-5. Swings through that. And down goes Diedrich. There are now two down.
Now batting, the catcher, number 25.
Andy Metcalf in now with two outs. Strikeout victim twice and hit by a pitch tonight. See if he can find it here against Elliott. Whew, follows that straight back. Knocks the umpire's mask right off and down goes Fraser. Not quite, but dazed. Yeah, knocked the helmet right off of him. Got to give him a second to regroup. Got the protective gear, but it's not fun. Catch one off the melon. Dazed, but okay. We'll do it again. 0-1 now to Metcalf. Max Elliott set, and here it comes. That's short. I'm going to say low, but it's just short. 1-1. One ball, one strike, two in the bucket. Three in for the Fish. 13-5 is the score. Hudson's favor. Max Elliott stares into Grant Corbett's. He's set, and here it comes. Fouled away, and it's now 1-2. The inning was led off by Josh Idem with an infield single. Gable singled, and Trey Larson tripled. Whoo, just missed. Max Elliott thought he had it. He was headed towards the dugout, and the umpire says, "Whoa, Nelly." Back to the mound, it's 2-2. The 2-2 pitch. And Mr. Lucas Lutke, it's a man after my own heart. He says, if they're going to give me a base, I'm going to take a base. And he steals third. So Lucas Lutke now stands at third with two outs. And it's a full count on Metcalf. And that is hit deep in the hole at short. Long throw across. Wow, what a play. What a play by shortstop Jack Erickson. Holy buckets. He was out into the outfield grass and then threw an absolute aspirin over to Sam Erickson at first base to retire Metcalf on a 6-3 ground out for the final out of the inning. But the Fish do plate three. They get three runs on three hits, no errors, and one left. Six in the books now from First National Bank at River Falls Field. 13-5, Hudson.
And a final from Pittsburgh, your Milwaukee Brewers beat the Pirates 7-2. JP Feiereisen and the Tampa Bay Rays are off today, but anytime they are playing, catch some Rays downtown at Johnny's Bar. They have the MLB package, and you can watch your favorite hometown pitcher, JP Feiereisen, in action.
Right.
spot.
5, 6, and 7 due up for Hudson here in the top of the seventh. Hunter Fry, Jason Holler, and Mitch Lewis. Dornick's ready. Throw her down. Let's go. Fry, Hunter Fry, makes his way to the plate.
The right fielder, number 4, Hunter Fry.
Hunter Fry has reached on an error, grounded out to short, grounded out to third, unassisted, and walked. Officially, 0 for 3 with a walk. Here we go. Top of the seventh. 13-5. Matt Dornick back on the bump for the Fighting Fish. The pitch. Low, ball one. Two and oh, that's down. Dornick set at the belt, rocks and delivers. Check swing in front of the plate. Dornick gathers onto first. Look out, wide throw. And that is headed to second base. Right fielder throws it in, and he is... What do you got? Out at second base.
Out! Out!
What do we got? A little conference now between the umpires. Let's see what they're going to call. Got him in. I think they're giving him second base, maybe on a ball that was out of play, maybe. That ball go out of play somewhere? I think maybe. That was a great hustle, though, by right fielder Ty Denzer to get to that baseball. He threw it in. Looks like they tagged him out. But umpires conversed. I think they said it was out of play, so he automatically gets second base on the errant throw. So that's going to be an E1. And on down to second goes Hunter Fry. Now we go to Jason Holler. Interesting. It must have been out of play over there. It must have hit something like in a dugout area or something. And then it caromed out into right field, and it was, again, a good hustle by Denzer to throw it to second base. Looks like they tagged him out, and the umpire said, no, that ball's out of play. He just automatically gets second base. That was a dead ball. So I think that's what happened there. Just for clarity. That's down. Now 2-1. Two balls and a strike on Jason Holler. A couple walks today. Strike out and a fly out. Officially 0 for 2. That finds the corner. Now it's 2-2. On left fielder Jason Holler. Six hole for Hudson. High. 3-2. Mitch Lewis waits on deck for the Hudson River Rats. 13-5 is the score. We're in the top of the seventh. Got him. Got him out in front. Took a little off of that and got Jason Holler swinging. There's one down.
Next up for the River Rats, the second baseman, number 2, Mitch Lewis.
Now we go to Mitch Lewis with one in the bucket. And Mitch Lewis, he's officially 0 for 2. He walked and scored and also hit by a pitch and scored. So he got on via walks and hit by pitches and scored both of those times. Flew out and grounded out. So officially 0 for 2 away. Ball gets away from the catcher, and on down to third goes the runner. And nice hustle there by Hunter Fry to get to third base on a pass ball. So Hunter Fry reaches on an error, gets the second on an overthrow, gets the third on a pass ball. Taking advantage of the fish mistakes, you might say. The 2-0 pitch fouled away. It's now 2-1. Emergency squad 51. Squad 51. We've got an emergency. The 2-1. Chopper foul. And we'll go to 2-2. Top of the seventh. 13-5 Hudson. Hudson has a runner at third with one out. We're at the seventh spot in the order. Second baseman Mitch Lewis. Joe Patterson waits on deck. Matt Dornick on the mound for the Fighting Fish. That hit him. And on down to first goes Mitch Lewis, hit by a pitch. Second time today he's been hit by a pitch. Now it's runners at the corners for Joe Patterson.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 34, Joe Patterson.
A conference on the mound. That's going to be all for Matt Dornick. He says, I've had enough of this, and I'm out. So Matt Dornick leaves, high fives as he enters the dugout. Chucky Batts gives him a high five in there. And that will be all. Let's see who's on the bump now for the Fighting Fish. Jeff Cook. On the mound now for River Falls, Jeff Cook.
Now pitching for the pitch, number 27, Jeff Cook.
That sounds like a big league name, like a big league relief pitcher name, Jeff Cook. Right? Nothing too fancy, just Jeff Cook coming in the seventh. Left-handed slinger. He's going to face the eight-hole hitter, designated hitter Joe Patterson, when he's ready. There's one out and runners at the corners for Hudson. Here we go, says the umpire. Well, then, let's go. Runners at the corners. One out. Hudson up 13-5. Jeff Cook rocks and slings. Whew, nice. High gas, 0-1. That got up on him quick. Brewers win tonight over Pittsburgh. That's always good. They got a nice winning streak going. The 0-1. Inside, gets away from the catcher. Could be a play at the plate or not. And Hunter Fry scores from third. And Mitch Lewis scampers in down to second base. 14-5. They get one of those back. Chopper. First base. Nice job by Cook to cover, and there's two down, and the runner advances to third. 3-1 if you're scoring along at home. Two down.
The third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
We go to Will Jellick, hitting in the nine spot. He's been nothing but lights out today. He's been up four times and scored four times. Officially, one for two, but he's been on via the walk twice as well. But Will Jellick in the nine hole has scored four times. Singled in the second and scored. Walked in the fourth and scored. Walked in the fifth and scored. Reached on a fielder's choice in the sixth and scored. Finds himself at 1-1 now against Jeff Cook for the River Falls Fighting Fish, who's just slinging the rock. The pitch. That's just high, 2-1. That's high, now 3-1. We're at the nine spot in the order. Nate Witte, the leadoff batter, waits on deck. 3-1. Look out, that's away. And Will Jellick garners himself a two-out free pass. Third walk of the game. Yes, he scored four.
Jellick has reached base five times tonight, and that brings up number 14, the center fielder, Nate Witte.
Nate Witte, leadoff batter. Pop straight up the chute. Play on the infield. First baseman, nice job out there by Spencer Diedrich to make the catch.
All right, fans, it's the middle
and
of
retire
the
Witte.
And time for Take Me Out to the Ball Game. Here we go.
So Witte flies out
it's
to first.
And, Cheryl Pittman up here in the
and that will do it.
Make sure to say thank
Hudson
you.
Does play to run. They get one run on no hits, one error, and two left. 6.5 in the books now. 14-5 Hudson. Looking ahead to the Fighting Fish, bottom of the seventh. 7, 8, and 9 are due up. Elliot, gutting an item.
Rats, number 32, Noah Berger.
Noah Berger now pitching for Hudson. Max Elliott's done, and Noah Berger gets the rock. Carter Elliott, couple hits today for the Fish, 2 for 3. Got a nice game.
Leading off for the Fighting Fish in the bottom of the seventh inning, the third baseman, number 13, Carter Elliott.
So Carter Elliott here in the bottom of the seventh, Fish down by 9. They're going to have to get on the hit parade here, huh? High and tight, ball one. The one ball pitch hit to the left side. Third baseman gets it on two hops. Crossed his body. Nice play. A nice scoop over there at first base by Erickson. And gets Carter Elliott on a ground out, four out number one.
Next up for the Fish. Number 9, Mitchell Fireisen
now in for the Fish, pinch hitting for Trevor Gunning. Look out! That almost under the armpits, almost got him, just missed him. It's 1-0 on Mitchell. Swings through that, it's now 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out, we're in the bottom of the seventh. It's 14-5, Huddy. High and tight, 2-1. Swings through that, now it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. It's like all the love, a pinch hitter on deck for the Fish as well. Next up, the 2-2. Followed back, we'll stick at 2-2. Miles Liebren waits in the on-deck circle. Just missed there. Now it's 3-2 on Mitchell Fireisen. Noah Berger rocks and delivers. It's away. Free pass for Mitchell and on down to first. He goes. Fish have a base runner. Miles Liebren.
Miles. Number 11, Miles Liebren.
There he is. He's been announced. It's official. Noah Berger delivers. That's high. Popping the leather, but 2 feet out of the strike zone. It's one ball and no strikes. Two and oh. Fitch got their work cut out for him. Down by 9 here in the 7th. Fouled away. Down the right field line into the outfield box seats about 11 rows back. It's now 2-1. I'm getting hungry. How about you folks at home? Have you eaten? I haven't. I had a bagel for dinner, kind of on the run. It was good, but it's wearing off. The 2-1 misses, now 3-1. Fish need base runners, so you can be fussy. And Miles Liebren trying to work his way on here in the 7th. That's at the knees, 3-2. Noah Berger delivers, misses, and back-to-back free passes for the Fish, and they do have base runners.
Next up for the Fish, the center fielder number 24, Brian Giebel.
So we're going back to the top of the order to Brian Giebel. He's hit the ball hard tonight and not been overly rewarded, though he does have one hit. He's 1-for-4. He scorched it the first couple times up. That's also hammered into left. Get up, ball! Get out of here! Gone! Brian Giebel! Touch him all! Giebs! Deep into the night! Circling the bags!
It's a home run!
Three-run jack for Brian Giebel! Put those three on the board. Yes. Got the barrel on that one and send it deep into the night. A three-run bomb by Brian Giebel. And a baby. Just like that, it's 14-8. Smoked it.
Now batting the shortstop, number 2, Trey Larson.
I said he's been hitting the ball hard all night, and he hit that one hard, too, and took it right out of here. Home run. Three-run variety. That was fun. No doubter. Left fielder Jason Holler just turned and watched it. Trey Larson palms up on that. He says, no way. 1-2 now on Larson. Broken bat, right side, slow roller. And first baseman will get to the bag, and he shatters the bat. There's two down. 3-0 on that. Two down. Now we go to Ty Denzer.
Now batting the right fielder, number 10, Ty Denzer.
Trey Larson, the home plate umpire, having some words. That's also hit well. Left side, left fielder calling and makes the catch. Nice job out there in left field by Jason Holler to retire Ty Denzer for out number three.
Johnny's Bar would like to raise the bar on a clean ballpark. Help the fish by putting your trash in the trash cans.
But the fish do plate three. They get three runs on one hit. The three-run bomb off the bat of Brian Giebel to make it a 14-8 baseball game after seven.
Johnny's Bar, raising the bar with good times and good friends.
So the fish are hanging around, you might say. Seemed like it was out of reach, but 14-8, it's getting within reach with a couple innings to play.
Ladies and gentlemen, news hot off the press from Bob Burrows. Your Milwaukee Bucks win by a final score of 123-112, and they take a 3-2 advantage in that Eastern Conference final series.
Without their big stud, who was injured, so that's good for the Bucks. 3-2 lead. That series has been back and forth, hasn't it? Back on the mound is Jeff Cook for the River Falls Fighting Fish. I'm starting to get weary. I think it's probably lack of food. It's been a long day. Come on in. There's someone knocking on the door. He can't get it. Oh, they tossed him. We got a brouhaha.
Ladies and gentlemen, the fine folks at Twin Cities Pita have just informed me, last call for food.
I don't know if there's been an ejection or not.
Time to retire.
Wow. Head coach Josh Item out there. Given Blue an earful, I don't think anybody's been ejected, but that got a little heated. I know that was all related to Trey Larson, and I'll talk about that in just a second here as we move to the top of the eighth inning. That's hit into right field. Right fielder is under it and makes the catch. Nice job out there by Ty Denzer. So Erickson lines out to Denzer and right for out number one. Line out to right, one down.
For the River Rats, the catcher, number 15, Isaiah Grant Corbett.
So Grant Corbett is up now with one out, one pitch, one out. I'll talk a little bit about that if I get a second here. Swinging through that. So what happened was, it's when Larson was up, there was an inside pitch called a strike. It did look inside. Trey went palms up and said, hey, that's inside. I can't hit that. The next pitch was about the same spot, the pitch here, hold on, about the same spot, and he swung at it and got it up on the grip tape, broke his bat and a slow roller, and then he said to the umpire, see, you can't hit that. It's on the grip tape. It's inside. And the umpire said, I'm not having any of that. Well, that conversation continued into the top of this inning, and the umpire, I guess, confronted Trey out at shortstop. And then the head coach, Mr. Josh Idem, got in the middle of that and says, hey, you leave my players alone unless you got a problem. And that was interesting. But Trey was making a point. Umpire didn't like it, and Idem stood in front of it. And you know what? After all that dust-up, nobody got ejected. Game on. One ball and two strikes now on Isaiah Grant Corbett. He's got a couple hits today, 2 for 5. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Yeah, wasn't that it, Greg? I mean, he complained about the inside pitch, swung at the next inside pitch and broke his bat and says, you can't hit that, is what he said to the umpire. You know? Right. He says, if you swing at that, this is what happens. You hit it on the grip tape, and I break my bat. That's a ball. And the umpire said, no, it's not. Hi, Choppa. Right back to the pitcher. He'll run it over to the first, flip it, out. And Grant Corbett grounds out to the pitcher. There's two outs. You know, whether Trey is accurate or not is kind of irrelevant. That's how he felt.
Jack Erickson.
And he let the umpire hear it, and the umpire says, no, you're wrong, Trey, I'm right. And Trey says, no, I'm right, you're wrong, and they had an argument. Fouled straight back, it's 0-1. Just a good old-fashioned dust-up at the ballpark. Haven't had one of those in a while. Fun. Nobody got ejected, though. Good old-fashioned brouhaha. Flowing up into right. Denzer hustling near the line and makes the kick. Oh, just misses it. Thought he had that. Maybe overran it by a titch. Into the bullpen area. That's just going to end up being a long strike. He was there. I think he just overran it. And we'll stick at 0-2. Two in the bucket here in the top of the eighth. I get a weird feeling about this game. Like the Fish might claw themselves back into this thing. The 0-2. That's flown also into right field. Denzer moves up a few steps and makes the catch at the bill of his cap. And that will do it. First 1-2-3 inning tonight.
Major League Baseball Hall of Famer Dave Winfield will be right here before the Fighting Fish.
Three up, three down. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left.
Grant provided by Major League Baseball.
7.5 in the books. 14-8. Hudson.
Youth Development Foundation. The ceremony will begin about 7 o'clock right after the American Legion game. The Fish will play following the short ceremony.
Meat of the order here for the Fish in the bottom of the eighth. 4, 5, and 6. Ludke, Diedrich, and Metcalf. Now you might want to phone a friend, call a neighbor, get him out of bed. This could get good. Fish down by just 6 with a couple, with 6 outs left. Six outs to get for Hudson. 6 runs to get for the Fish. 4, 5, and 6. Lucas Ludke, there he is. He'll lead it off here in the bottom of the eighth for the Fighting Fish.
Leading off for the Fighting Fish, the second baseman, number 3, Lucas Luki.
Ludke looks at a strike on the outside corner of the arm of Noah Berger. Hit to the left side. Third baseman gathers it. Boy, he's been solid over there all game tonight. Will Jellick fielding his position well and retires Lucas Ludke on a 5-3 ground out. Boy, he's been solid
next
over there.
Next up for the Fighting Fish, it's the first baseman, number 28, Spencer Diedrich.
Spencer Diedrich is in now with one out and looks at a strike. Spencer, he's got himself a hit tonight and a walk. Officially 1-for-3. Hit past the third baseman. Tell you what, he's been lights out over there, has been Jellick, but he's not going to get that rocket. That one was 101 coming off the bat. Absolutely scorched.
Catcher, number 25, Andy Metcalf.
Now we go to Andy Metcalf, the catcher. Yeah, that ball was scorched, squared up, and just hammered into left field. Jellick gave it a dive, but wasn't going to get there. 101 miles an hour off the bat there, Jugs Gunn says. That was scorched. Yep. Everyone going to fact check that. It was somewhere between 97 and 103. I pick 101. One ball, one strike, one out. That's low. Now 1-2, 2-1. Fish down by 6. You need base runners. The 2-1. That's fouled straight back. Now it's 2-2. Metcalf looking for his first hit tonight. He's been on once. He was hit by a pitch in the fifth. The 2-2. Ooh. Umpire rings him up. Metcalf not real happy about that. There's two outs now. We go to Carter Elliott. Let me see, got a pinch hitter maybe. Matt Bacon is in. Matty Bacon. You know, his family was on earlier. I hope they stuck around.
Number 23. Matt Bacon.
So Matty Bacon is in. Looks at a strike. Didn't like it. But he's in with two outs. That's down now 1-1 to Matt Bacon. Runner at first, two in the bucket, Bacon at the dish. The 1-1, that finds the corner, now it's 1-2. His strike zone might be getting a titch wider. The 1-2 to Matt Bacon, chopper to short, high hoppa. He'll step on second base and get the force out at second for out number 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause once again for the River Falls Swim Club
six
for volunteering in the concession
out
stand
number tonight. 3.
And a huge tip of the cap to Johnny's Bar and owners Dave and Cheryl Pittman for sponsoring tonight's game.
Well, the fish get a hit. They get one hit.
And speaking of Johnny,
no runs on one hit, no errors, and one left. There's eight in the books. 14-8, Hudson. Oh. All right. He hit that hard. Matty hit that hard. High hopper. Nice play by shortstop Jack Erickson. He got to that high chopper, and then he stepped on his own sack out there at second and got the force, and that was it. Bang of fire. Burns, burn. Ring of fire. Tell you what, Jeff Cook has done a nice job for the Fish, slinging the rock. This literally, the lefty is a slinger. Sling it right in there. Last inning, he retired Hudson 1, 2, and 3. Hunter Fry, Jason Holler, and Mitch Lewis do up for Hudson here in the top of the ninth. The Ring of Fire. Skipped in there, ball one. Yeah, I think they put Matty Bacon over at second base and Lutke to third. That one's hit into right center, and that's down for a leadoff single, maybe more. On to second, hustling goes Hunter Fry, and he is in. Hunter Fry with a hustle double that he hit into exactly right center field. Hunter Fry with leadoff double here in the top of the ninth. Nice piece of hitting and running for Hunter Fry. Split him perfectly out there in right and center field. Now we go to Jason Holler. Jason's still looking for his first hit tonight. He struck out twice, walked twice, and flew out. Fouls that back. It's 0-1.
River Rats number 17, Taylor Matter.
Oh, Taylor Matter. We got a pinch hitter. Thank you, Greg. Taylor Matter batting for Jason Holler. So I described Jason Holler's night, but it's Taylor Matter in there. He's nothing for nothing. Jeff Cook set and delivers. That's a nice back ankle breaker there. It's 0-2 on Taylor Matter. It's Hunter Fry out there at second base, let off with a double. That's hit towards third. Lutke all the way across, and it gets past the first baseman, and a run will score. I don't know if we're going to score that hit or error. I'm watching the board. Error on the third baseman. Tough error. Lutke got that behind third base, threw across a little bit into the dirt over there at first, but tough play. Scored that E5. Run does score.
Mitch Lewis.
Runner makes it to second base. Now we go to Mitch Lewis. Yeah, Lutke just moved over to third, and the ball found him. 15-8. Still nobody out. Runner at second. Double and an E5. And Taylor Matter winds up at second base. Yeah, Lutke got in, you know, it was a tough play. He caught himself, I think, almost on the foul line behind third base. And it was going to be a long throw, and he had to hurry. Threw it just a little bit low. And Spencer Diedrich couldn't quite scoop it out. Oh, I'll take one of those. I'll take one of those. You got any ketchup? I'll take mustard. You bet. That's a walk. There's a walk. First and second now with nobody out. I'll take one of those.
The designated hitter. Number 34, Joe Patterson.
Joe Patterson now comes up with nobody out. And runners at first and second. Look out, that's to the backstop, and the runners will move up. Second and third. Joe Patterson. Oh, I'm so hungry. That's awesome. That's good. Thank you. Yeah, just a little bit more. Oh, yeah, I can get that. I can get her. Look at that. I got a nice Johnsonville brat with some mustard on it right here. I might, if I go quiet here for a little bit, I'm eating a brat, people. 2-1. Fall straight back onto the grandstand. It's 2-2. Run scores. Run scores on a pass ball. Taylor Matter scampers in. Mitch Lewis gets over to third. 16-8. Still nobody out. Three balls, two strikes is the count. On Joe Patterson. Walked him. I think. He thinks. Everybody thinks. Everybody's like wondering, and he's on down to first. Runners at the corners now with nobody out.
Now batting the third baseman, number 27, Will Jellick.
Will Jellick. What a night. Been on five times tonight. Scored four. Great game at third base. If we had a player of the game, he'd be in the running. Sorry about that. Meeting a brat. Here, I'll bring you into the booth. I may have some mustard on my face. Here we go. This is what we're doing up here right now. This is a brat. This is a hungry face right here, so... Look at that mustard on there. That's pretty good. Thanks for coming up in the booth with me.
Now batting, the center fielder, number 14, Nate Whitty.
So Jellick goes down. I jinxed him. One out. How'd that brat look? I'm just going for a brat at 10:35 at night. I guess I'll eat one if I haven't eaten all day, and that's pretty much my case. One down. Runners at the corners for Hudson. They've plated two this inning. It is 16-8. Back to the top of the order. Nate Whitty fouls that back. It's 0-2. Oh and two. Ooh, nice pitch there by Jeff Cook. Paints the corner. Drops that deuce in there. And now there are two down. After back-to-back strikeouts.
Next up for the nice. Rats, number three, Sam Erickson.
I like Jeff Cook. He's got some game for the fish on the mound. Nice fresh arm slinging it in there to the lefty. Sam Erickson now looks at a ball. Straight up to shoot. Second baseman calling. Now the first baseman calling. Now nobody's got it. And the ball drops. Matty Bacon says, I got it. And he said, no, I don't. And Spencer Diedrich said, I got it. And he said, no, I don't. And the ball fell right between them. Base hit. Base hit. Run scores.
Now batting the catcher, number 15, Isaiah Grandcorpus.
That wasn't really pretty, but it was a base hit. Nobody touched it. Grand Corbett swings through that. It's 1-1. Isaiah Grand Corbett has a couple hits tonight. He's got two hits. Two runs scored. Chopper to third. Gathered. On to first. Lutke throws him out. And that will do it for Hudson here in the top of the ninth. They do get three more runs on two hits, an error, and two left. After 8.5, it's 17-8. Hudson. Nine-one to up for the fish.
Leading out for the Fighting Fish in the bottom of the ninth inning, number 9. Mitchell Fireizen.
Nice healthy hack there by Fireizen. He walked and scored his last time up. Just away, now 1-1 on Mitchell. I was able to finish that brat, but now who's got the Tums? Someone passed the Tums. I'm good. It hits a spot, though. It hit him. Oh, hit him in the hand. Ouch, 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 ouch. That's going to leave a mark. Hit him in the wrist. Not happy about that, and that hurt. About where the hand meets the bat. And that hurt. I'm going to put down a hit by pitch. We'll see if Mitchell is going to stay in the game or not. Doesn't look like it. He's headed to the clubhouse, and it looks like we'll have a pinch runner. Chucky Batts, Charlie Griffin. That hurt. Hope he's okay.
Now batting number 11, Miles Liebrin.
So Miles Liebrin is after the hit by pitch. Miles Liebrin is in here in the bottom of the ninth. Fish down by a touchdown and a field goal. They can take the lead. Grounder to second. We'll go to first and get the out. 4-3 in your scorebook. One out.
Next up for the Fighting Fish, number 4, Jason Hunt.
Jason Hunt now in for Brian Giebel. looks at a strike. Yeah, Giebel, three-run homer last time up, and a couple hits for today. And he said, hit the showers, son, and let Jason Hunt hit here in the ninth. Looks at two strikes. It's 0-2 on Jason Hunt. Fish down to their final two outs. Look out. That's a breaking ball that didn't break. It's 1-2. I hope Mitchell's okay. Got him like on the right where his hand meets the bat and took himself out. He looked like he was in a little bit of pain. And that will do it for Jason Hunt, swinging third strike, two down. Now we go to Trey Larson. Let's see if
now batting
this would be
the shortstop number two, Trey.
Let's see if
Larson.
Trey just goes about his business or gives the umpire an earful. Let's see. Calls a strike. 0-1. Trey might have knew that as he kind of swung through it after it went by. The 0-1 pitch to Larson. That's down now, 1-1. Two down, Fish down to their final out. It's 17-8. Hudson. It's been all Hudson all night long. Flown up. Shortstop calling. He drops the baseball. And then almost got Larson at first. He wasn't running it out. Almost got him, but just safe. And run does score on the dropped ball by shortstop Jack Erickson, who's had such a nice game tonight. Just dropped that easy pop-up on the infield. And Larson reaches.
Now that, the right fielder,
and
number
the
10,
run scores.
Ty Pinser.
I'm not sure what the line was on the game tonight, but that might have been one of those bad beats right there, and they went on the over. But I think they hit the over a long time ago. I think they hit the over a long time ago tonight, so it probably wasn't a bad beat there. That's hit well. Fielder's moving over, and center fielder says, I'll take that, and that will do it. So
ladies and gentlemen, there's your final score.
Nate Whitty
Hudson
says, I'll take that and just finish this thing. So
Fighting Fish 9.
That will do it tonight.
Once again, thanks to Johnny's Barter for sponsoring tonight's game. The Fighting Fish will play tomorrow night in Osceola and battle the Braves. Game time starts at 7:30.
Your final tonight from First National Bank of River Falls Field. The Hudson River at 17. River Falls Fighting Fish 9 in St. Croix Valley Baseball League action. Winning pitcher tonight will be Owen Anderson, who pitched through 6. Losing pitcher, I think, will be probably Charlie Griffin. I believe. Another brat's in front of me, but there's no way I'm going to be able to eat that.
Encouraged to run the bases.
Well, thank everybody for joining us tonight on behalf of the River Falls Fighting Fish Baseball Club, First National Bank of River Falls Field, the skipper, Josh Item. I am Kevin Westhouse saying thanks again for joining us, everybody. And until next time, good night.